In this lesson, we'll study about gradients, purpose and factors affecting the selection of gradients. Actually, there are different types of gradients. So, we'll see which type to select for which factor. Let us start with the definition first. Now, in this video, if you can see, I've shown you the gradient of a road. So, here if you observe, there is a gradient like this. Now, this is what? A straight road. Okay, there is no much gradient in this. Right. So, this is for road. We have to deal it with for the railways now. So, to understand the definition, it is nothing but the rise or fall provided to the formation of a railway track along its alignment. This is known as your gradient, or it's sometimes also called as your grade. So let me write the definition. The rate of rise or fall provided to the formation of a railway track. Suppose it is road, you can take it as road. Okay. Along its alignment. Alignment is what? The route in which you are putting your railway track. Okay. This is known as your gradient, or it's also called as what? Grade. Just grade. Understood. Now there is one more definition for this gradient. So if you want to write that, it is the longitudinal slope provided to the track. So what slope? It is a longitudinal slope, and it is expressed as the ratio of vertical distance by horizontal distance. Vertical distance by horizontal distance. So let me write the definition. The longitudinal slope provided to the track and is expressed as the ratio of rise or fall, nothing but vertical distance, to the horizontal distance. Okay, grade is nothing but vertical distance by horizontal distance. Here, rise or fall is nothing but what? Vertical distance, as I mentioned earlier. So, if you want to write it in the form of notation, it is small h by d. Small h is the vertical distance and d is the, capital D is the horizontal distance. If you want to express in percentage also, you can do it small h by capital D into 100. But majorly, we use without percentage in India. Okay, now let me take the diagram. Say, suppose this is the alignment in which your road has to go, and this is the ground level what we have along the length. Ground level along the length. Now let me take a track here. This is how the track has to be there, right? So this is your formation level of the railway track, or vertical distance small h, horizontal distance capital D, between the point A and B. Say this I take as B dash. This angle is theta. Okay, now here what is happening? We have to do the cutting. We have to remove that much of earthwork. And here what's happening? We have to do the filling. We have to fill that much of earthwork. Right. Now this is your up gradient. So the gradient is given by what? Vertical distance h by the horizontal distance d. So in up gradient, h will be downward. In down gradient, h will be upward. That's how we write the formula h by d for the gradient. Okay, say suppose we take an example. Say if the track ascends or descends. Ascends means what? Goes up. Descends means what? Come down. Say 1 meter in every 50 meter horizontal distance. So in that case, there is a rise or fall of 1 meter, ascend or descend of 1 meter for every horizontal distance of how much? 50 meter. Then your gradient will be what? 1 in 50, or you can write it as 1 by 50. Now if you want to write it in percentage, what will happen? 1 by 50 into 100 you will have to do. That will give you what? 2%. So this is how you will express your gradient. This is just an example I quoted here. Okay. Move further and study what are the purposes of providing gradients. So gradients are provided to the formation of railway track to achieve the following purposes. Let's list one by one. The first one is to reach the destination situated at different altitudes. Say at different heights if you have the station, then to reach that point we need gradient. Right. So to reach the destination stations situated at different altitudes. Altitudes are nothing but different heights. That's your first purpose. Moving on to the second one is to provide uniform rate of rise or fall as far as practically possible. Okay, so we need to make sure that we have a uniform rise and uniform fall. It should not be random, so that it will be uncomfortable to the passenger to move along the track. So we need to provide what? Uniform rate of rise or fall. Moving on to the third purpose. So third purpose is what? To economize the earthwork. What do you mean by economize? See, there should not be too much of digging also involved. There must not be too much of filling also involved. We have to make sure that we economize the earthwork which is used. Okay, moving on to the fourth one is to provide a easy drainage for the rain water. So whenever rain occurs, the drain of the rain water should be very easy. In such a way, we have to provide the gradient. Gradient is nothing but, in simple terms, if you want to understand, nothing but the slope. Okay. Now, what are the factors that will affect the gradient is important. Now, once we know the purpose, we have to move on to the factors. So, the gradient in the design of railway track is very, very important, especially as its economical alignment. Okay. So, once provided to the formation of the track, it forms the permanent feature of the track. Especially in urban and built-up areas, we cannot change it. Therefore, it's a permanent feature. Whatever gradient we are providing, it's a permanent feature. So, we have to do a complete analysis of the factors which will affect the gradient before deciding how much of gradient we are providing. Okay. So, if we want to list out, the following are the various factors which govern the selection of a particular gradient in the alignment of a railway track. So there are totally five important factors. So let us list one by one now. The first one is what? The nature of the ground. So what type of ground we have chosen, and at every interval there will be a different type of nature of ground. So based on that, your gradient will be decided. The first one is what? Nature of the ground. Second one is the total height to be covered. So from one destination to another destination, how much of total height has to be covered? That will be the second factor which will affect the selection of the type of gradient. Total height to be covered. Next, drainage required. How much of drainage is required? Based on that also, a selection of gradient will happen. Drainage required. Next, moving on to the fourth one, it's the hauling capacity of the railway engine. What is hauling capacity? The hauling capacity is nothing but the capacity of the train to pull all the bogies forward or backward. So how much of hauling capacity is there for a particular type of railway engine? That is also one of the important factors which will affect the selection of the gradient. Understood. The train has less hauling capacity and we have a steep gradient, it is very difficult for the train to pull all the bogies up direction. Okay. So then moving on to the fifth one, it's the safety required. Very, very important. We cannot have gradients on which moving of railway trains will become unsafe. Okay, so we need to have a safe gradient. So these are all the factors that are affecting the gradient. In the next lesson, we will study about the types of gradients. Thank you.